We're going to start here in just a second. I think this is going to work. I'm trying out all these new toys and stuff. We're going to talk about starting out without a hot dog cart. Okay, I got a question, but before I do that, I have something exciting I want to share. I have a vendor that sent me, you know how you like feel good stuff? This is a feel good. This is like a story of determination. So I want to read you part of that email that I got, and I got his permission to share part of it. He didn't want to give his location and stuff. Don't blame him. He didn't want extra competition. Kind of like the interview I did the other day with the guy at the port. So you can understand that, I'm sure. So here's the deal. Well, I'm going to answer this about starting without a cart for, that was for Ricky. I'll read his comment. He commented here on a YouTube video and asked that question. I keep looking over here because I'm checking the system for my signal strength. I'm going to post this up here in case I forget it later. And I want to tell you, hi, Mick. Hey, let's see. Petty Mandorna. Either way, howdy, Petty. Thanks for being here. Bugs, thanks for being here. Afternoon from Boston Street Eats and Catering. I love that. Street Eats and Catering. You can tell the people that are doing their due diligence and following the stuff we teach. And do you see the name? Street Eats and what? Catering. And we're fixing to talk about that a little bit. But first, I want to read you something. Bear with me. Mr. Stoneley's in the house. Michael Grosso's here. David Bogan's here. Nessa G is in the house. Thanks for being here. And I'll get to some more of you. I posted in, right above you in the chat box, two links that you may want to copy and paste for later, because you might need them. Okay, just save them. Steve, the horror obese. Hello, Ben. Howdy, Steve. Glad you're here. Okay, so I'm going to do an uplifting email that I got permission to share it, and then I'm going to answer this question that came in from Ricky. Okay, so I've already got stuff scheduled for tomorrow. And tomorrow I'll be on the road all day. I got a 9-hour trip ahead of me. And so I'm going to be doing it from the phone, and we'll see how that works out. But we've got some cool stuff to cover. Cool stuff to cover. So if you're in the learning stage, or even if you're in the growing stage, there's something here for you. Okay, the first one. This is an email. Okay, I'm going to turn this starting soon off, because that's just stupid now, isn't it? Let's see. Look right here. That's just my plain Jane one. All right. And then I'll share another one for you here in just a second. But let me move this out of my way so I can read this email. Ben, I got my LLC last February, always wanted a hot dog cart, always searched them out at carnivals, fairs, always on the lookout. In 1992, I went to Virginia from California to sell Super Bowl t-shirts. I set up on the street in Hampton Roads area, okay, next to a hot dog stand. You can see this coming, right? Inspiration. He was retired. This is how he spent his retirement. It was at that time that I caught the bug. I know that feeling, okay? See, already, look at this. Can you see that? That's chill bumps, baby. Chill bumps. Okay, I was a massage therapist for over 25 years, and now I'm making my dream a reality. I bought the Pro Dog. That's our Pro Dog, and I'm going to show you a picture. Let me put up the picture real quick. Look at that. I'm getting fancy. I got a picture right here, right there. Right there. Okay. So, you can see his Pro Dog has the griddle on the left there, and on the right, a full size steam table, restaurant size, commercial. So, I caught the bug, and then, let's see. And then I bought the Pro Dog, and then with all the doors slammed, end quotes, you cannot do that here. First of all, here in Virginia, you only need a health department inspection, fire inspection, and you can get a license. But But this doesn't mean you can sell. You must get a license in all counties and cities in which you want to vend, plus written permission from the landowners. That's why we give away those permission slips free, okay? Not those leasing or renting the property, which are controlled by lawyers. It's been a real pain. But every time I get discouraged, I go back to your book. He's talking about my book, Hot Dog Saved My Life. Okay, if you don't know that, just go to hotdogsavedmylife.com book, right? So, and it always comes back to, you've done all this work, money and time, why stop now? After printing and filling out forms and more forms, still waiting for answers in one county, the other county in the past 2 weeks have gone from the first time I called and she said, you can't do that here, to delivering papers all ago maybe, until last Thursday I showed up at a zoning to deliver two letters from landowners. She said I had to go to the licensing office first. So he did his due diligence. He goes and gets the letters, brings them back, and they go, oh no, you have to go to the license department first. And what does he say? Let me find, licensing office first. Want to make sure they get their share. So I left the permission letters there. By the time I got the other office, they denied the places I had submitted due to requiring parking. So the town he's in is requiring parking. Like they want to know that there's plenty of room for parking for your cart. Okay. So I wouldn't lose my temper. I went out to the parking lot and I called zoning and told them that I will call every day and submit names of places to see if they qualify before asking for permission from landowners, that I was not going to go away. And he puts not in capitals, not going to go away. You don't see the picture? Oh, that's because I didn't send it. So sorry about that. I suck sometimes. I'm glad you said something though. David, thank you. It's okay to have someone run dogs like at a ballpark. Can someone take hot dogs on the beat, so to speak? I'm going to talk about some of that. I may not get to that today. You may want to, I may have to do that later. Okay, so, in fact, it's answered in the links above. It is. So I left permission letters there. Let's see. Okay. So I went up and emailed the district superintendent and told him my issue and added, in capitals, I just want to sell hot dogs, ! Anyways, at 4:00, I received a call from zoning. She said that as long as I have permission from the landowners, I can sell anywhere in the county. They would overlook the required parking thing just for me. Yes. So our first day was last Saturday, worked 4 hours at a local car wash. Everyone said, and he took a picture. See, that's the picture right there. It's on one of these fingers. The end of one of these fingers is pointing to a picture. Okay. I just want to sell hot dogs and got set up, blah, blah, blah. I went to the wrong line. So our first day was Saturday and they will never, and the car wash said they will never give you an appointment. Had a blast though, and we cleared over 200. That's net for the day. Okay. Most vendors work 11 to 2. Okay. Just so you know, they get there about 10:30, set up, start vending 11, leave at 2:30. They're gone, cleaned up, gone. Okay. So, $200 and already booked two dates for one of the local craft breweries. Okay. Now I'm going to bleep this part, but this is, I'm quoting, thank you so effing much, my friend, ! All in caps. Your book has helped make my dreams come true. We're booked every single Friday and Saturday at the car wash and 2 to 3 days at a professional office park during the week. I have truly learned patience and appreciate you, my friend, for doing all the hard work for the rest of us. I don't think I did the hard work for you, brother. I did not do the hard work for you here. You're the one that did all this. You walked this out. You stomped a mud hole in it and walked it dry. And that's impressive. That's called determination. That's called getting shit done. And I'm proud of you. I mean, freaking love you. That's awesome. I have truly learned patience. Okay, I read that. When a person's job only allows them to say no, then you're talking to the wrong people. Through this experience, I have taught the state health department what the card is, the fire department, and each county as I have gone through the process. Thanks again. And he gives me his name and the name of his business and his website. That's a picture. I think it's this finger. Yeah, that's it. That's it. It's working. I can see it. So is that not freaking awesome? Now to get to the meat, I got more meat for you. We're going to talk about starting. Here's the question that came in, okay? This is the question that came in. Let me pull this up real quick. This is the top dog, Ricky Jensen. Okay, he comments on videos sometimes here. I finally started my part-time job to build the funds to get going. When I'm driving around town, I now look for location possibilities for when I get started. If my plan goes as followed, I'll be getting fully started by April of 2019. Now that's giving yourself a year, right? Which is smart. But, he says, I keep thinking, should I start small and cared at events with, taking whatever folding tables to events and propane burners. Should I just be patient and stick and go with my plan and save money to get a cart and start next year? Or should I start small and get my catering on? Any advice I can receive from anyone who sees this, feel free to send some advice. Love seeing these videos, Ben. Okay, that was from the top dog, Ricky Jensen. Ricky, I love this because I've had some of these before where somebody messaged me or emailed me or left me a voicemail and told me something like this, that by this time I'm starting, and they did. And it makes my head just swell bigger than hell. I get so freaking happy when I see people do this. Okay, you've made a plan. You're going to make it and make an action on that plan, and you're going to see it through. Now, your question is, should you start something in between? Abso-freaking-lutely. You don't have to buy nothing, okay? You don't have to buy a cart. You can start without a cart, okay? Let me pull this up real quick. I lost it. There she is. I'm going to give you this. Okay, here's, this should change. Booyah. If you go to that link right there, okay, and I put it in the chat thingy widget, and in the video description, you go to that link, you'll see real vendors who started they read this and started with little to no money, okay, and did it, and like double did it, and I've interviewed them, and their videos are here on YouTube and on the blog. I've got proof. So if you follow these steps, it's digging a hole. Remember, digging a hole. We can all dig a hole. Even if we don't even know what a shovel looks like, we can dig a hole. Even if we're only taught the basics and we use the wrong end of the shovel, we can still get a hole. It's just going to take a lot longer. But if you've got guidance and you've got the patience and determination, you can make things happen. Well, already we know Ricky's got the patience. He's setting a goal for next April. That's 11 months from now. Okay? He's saying next April. But he's wanting to start now. And he's wanting to know, can I start just a little bit? Can I start catering? Yep, guess what? You can. Find out. And I give you all the actions to take. It's as simple as looking something up, okay? You can Google it, find out what your state requires, or just call the state and go, listen, I want to start catering. What's the licensing requirements with the health department? Oh, we don't require them. Some states don't require them, okay, at all for catering. So you could literally make it, like in Tennessee, you can make your food at your house and cater without a license. You still have to have a business license, but nothing to do with the health department. Nothing to do with them, okay? So there's things you can do to make this work. I shared a story, and I don't have the link handy, but I shared a story of a lady who started, let me see if I can find this. This makes me mad when I think of these things afterwards. She literally was living in a motel. This is the second customer I've had in 9 years living in a freaking motel. Okay. There's two articles to this. Okay. But I'm going to give you one of these and I want you to see, this lady, this blew my mind. This was just last year. There you go. Right there. Okay? So, there's, did I give you the right one? Single mom. Yeah, single mom and donuts. She started with donuts that she wasn't even making. She was delivering donuts to car lots and stuff and business parks. And was having to, you should sit here, just listen to her story. And then to go from there to a cart to a food truck. I'm telling you, if you want to do this, people are eating every day. Doesn't matter if the economy's going up or going down. People are eating every day. Guess what happens when the economy sucks, though? They eat out more. It's an inexpensive way, in relatively inexpensive, compared to going and buy yourself a new jet ski, right? It's a relatively inexpensive way to treat ourselves. We work our butts off. We all like to treat ourselves. So people eat out in an effort to treat themselves. In the Depression era, guess what the number one thing that boomed during the Depression? Movie theaters. Movie theaters in the 30s. I'm talking silent movies, and I believe they had talkie movies too, but those movies were the number one hit. Movies were the number one hit during the Depression. That business, boom, skyrocketed. Everything else was collapsing, and that skyrocketed. Why? Because people could afford it, and it was a cheap release, a cheap pat on the back. You did a good job this week. Let's go to the movies. Okay? So I can remember being just dead broke and being just eating Spam and macaroni and cheese broke on food stamps before I started my hot dog cart and working my butt off and telling my wife, we're going to KFC. We're going to treat ourselves to some KFC. We're getting a bucket of chicken. So it made me feel good. It made the family feel good. So these little things, people will always eat. And I know I got sidetracked there, but I'm telling you, this is a bulletproof business. Bulletproof. You do step A, B, C, you win. You win every time. And that's what I freaking love. I got to read some of your comments real quick. So in case I missed anything that is, okay. I'm looking through. Don't worry. I should have music during this part. Is to go have someone run dogs to the ballpark, like at a ballpark. Can someone take hot dogs on the beat? So, oh, I see what you're saying. You're talking like at the ballpark, they're slinging dogs. Can you do that on the beat? There's ways to do that. Some states, it would still fall under the health department codes. Some would allow it if each one's already prepackaged and could be stored at a temperature that's safe. But if they have a ballpark and they allow it, they have to allow it for you as long as you can maintain the standards by the state for temperature control. And I don't know if you've seen them, but they make, in the UK, vendors use these. They're walk-around carts. And they're a backpack with propane tanks on your back, these thin propane tanks, that come up to a steam table right in front of you. It's like half-size steam table or a third-size steam table, little bitty thing. And they make dogs right there. It's got an umbrella over their head. And they walk around and serve dogs. They are close to a commissary that we were talking about yesterday. So they can refill, restock. Or take a break from the 80-pound weight thing they're carrying around. Mr. Stoneley says it's easier to ask for forgiveness than it is to get permission. Abso-freaking-lutely. But sometimes you don't want, you know, the po-po, as my niece calls it, the po-po pulling up. And telling you or writing you a ticket or saying, oh, you violated some code ordinance, we're confiscating your crap. I don't know if that could happen. I've seen it happen in California and New York. Never heard of it in any other state. What kind of age requirements are there for starting up a cart? Great question, Matthew. I interviewed a guy, a kid who was 9, on here, live. It's been a few years ago. He was in Florida, St. Pete area. His dad actually would drop him off with the cart. He'd set it up. He'd run it. He did everything. He was 9. 9. I interviewed him right on the show. He made his summer money doing that cart. So, I don't know that there is any age restriction. It may require an adult to get a license for the child. Okay, the adult gets the license, the child works the cart, right? Okay, hey, Owen Lewis here. Thanks for being here, Owen. So skip the cart, make dogs, and run around and sell them. I got you. You just want to check that. It's going to be touch and go with that one. You're going to have to get permitted. I'm 99.9% sure. I'm positive. Okay. Bug says start with lemonade. You know, the other day we talked about this. I updated the lemonade page. Okay. I needed to update it. We've been preaching it for 3 or 4 years now. Let me find this for you. I'm going to put it in the links so you have it. This is lemonade vending to hot dog vending. Wait till you see this. You're going to want to kiss me. Okay? Here you go. There's the link. That will get you to how to start with lemonade. And I put on the title lemonade to vending. You don't have to go to vending. I mean, you don't have to go to hot dog vending. You can go to just lemonade vending. I got a good friend that does it. Okay? He makes a buttload. In fact, is it this Saturday? Yeah, I've had a family emergency. So this Saturday I was supposed to be with Ken Packer and his lemonade stand. And I just thought about this. I'm not going to be able to go because we've had a family. We've got somebody really, really, really sick and they're young. And we got to go out of town. So bottom line is that's why I'm going to be on the road tomorrow. So I won't be at that. But I'll do the next one he's got. He gave me 4 dates. Okay. Let me see when the next date is. He's got one on 5/26, May 26, and I can go see him then. Okay. And so I'll try to work that out, and he's going to have both setups going, hot dog cart and the lemonade stuff. I'm going to film it live. I'll take your questions live. That was my goal for this Saturday. It was going to be a surprise. I just remembered, this is how scatterbrained I am today, that I can't do that now. So next one. Joe, thank you very much. He says, great story. Thanks for sharing. I appreciate that. He's from Sunshine Hot Dogs and Catering. See, catering. There's a reason behind that. If you just search the word catering at learnhotdogs.com, you'll see why. There's a reason behind that. Ben, preach it. You have a ton of videos and articles about this. Thank you, Owen. Mario, on your feet. It's time to get this hot dog meat. Ben, soon I'm going to be in action. A little nervous, though. I'm grateful for your expertise. Thank you, Mario. I've not heard that one before. On your feet. It's time to get this hot dog meat. I like that, brother. You ought to put a little beat to that. I'm going to have to hire somebody to put a beat to it. That's freaking awesome. So I think I got everybody. Mac and cheese, you were rich. I survived on popcorn. There was times me and my wife were not eating so our kids could eat. Like literally sell half our food stamps for 50 cents on the dollar so that we could pay an electric bill so that we could still have enough food for the kids. And then we had to scrimp on that. Pathetic, but that's why I'm glad they have food stamps for people, because I dang sure needed them. Anyway, I appreciate the heck out of getting the shared emails, the comments, and everything. I really appreciate this vendor who took it all the way. You know, like I said, he stomped a mud hole in his state and walked it dry. Okay? He made that happen. And that's impressive. He wasn't going to say no. He was not going to quit. He was going to make it happen. And I like that. I went to eat the other day at a little restaurant. And they had Nathan's Jumbo Dogs. Look at this price. Now, this is in the hills. Okay? This is in the mountains. This is where people literally, you know, probably 80% of them are on food stamps. Look up the Appalachian Mountains and see. Okay? Look right here. Nathan's Jumbo Hot Dog. Look how much. And this is a little tiny joint. They're selling a quarter pound Nathan's dog, and then for chili, you got to add 50 cents. So $5.79 for a chili dog. And people are buying it. They were in line buying it. So, see, people treat themselves. They may be getting paid $7 an hour at work. And at the end of the week, you know what? I'm gonna get me some lunch. I ain't eating a peanut butter sandwich today. And so this is what changes. And then you start doing this, you're able to help more people. We've got vendors like Mark Lawler, Jason Brown, Corey Lawrence, John Cavanaugh before he passed away. All tons of vendors. Michael Wood. I could go on. Kim Packer. There's just a bunch of them that help people now. They've gotten successful and they have reached, they've gotten that dream and they and now are doing this. Jason Brown was a police officer, a canine cop, got hit by a drunk driver in the hospital for months and months. I mean, tore up surgery after surgery. Started a hot dog cart. Now has food trucks. Now is running the conspiracy food truck crew. I mean, just freaking fantastic. There's so many opportunities and stuff in this for you. It's just impossible to fail. Failure only, and this isn't some like poster, okay? You don't go to a poster company and buy this poster that's BS. I got a video about the BS, so you can do anything you want to do. Bull crap. I want to be an astronaut. Not going to happen. Doesn't matter how hard I try at this point. Well, at any point. I didn't have enough IQ points. Yeah, I think you have to be 6 points above a plant. I ain't even that. So my point is this is something that anyone can do. And it's 100% fail proof if you do it and you do it right. You don't have three bad days and go, oh, I'm hanging it up. I'm hanging it up. This sucks. I knew I shouldn't have quit truck driving. I knew I shouldn't have quit working rescue. I knew I shouldn't have quit digging ditches for a living. I knew I should have stayed at McDonald's. I was almost manager. If you have that in you, that drive that I just shared that email with you, that kind of drive, and you follow these steps, you will win every freaking single time. No doubts. Okay, Mr. Stoneley says, I fix cars, it's hard work, no money, and I hate cars. I couldn't begin to fix a car, so kudos to you. I don't have a mechanical type mind. I have to follow instructions on which end of the, you know, YouTube, which end of the hammer to use. That's just me. Now, once I'm shown, I'm pretty good. But you change stuff up on me, give me a different type of hammer, and now I got to go back to YouTube and look it up. The fixing cars, a lot of vendors have left that. I'm not telling you to jump off the train and come over here. The pasture's green over here. Because I can tell you this, we can go right now. I can call up 100 vendors. We can do a party line together, okay? I've got a software program that'll let us do a party line. We ought to do that one day, okay? Do this huge party line, and we'll go through each vendor and ask them, is this hard work? Yep. Do you get a lot of days off a year? Yep. Do you make good money? Yep. Can you make more if you want? Yep. I don't care if I got vendors, no joke, that I've trained, that I've helped. I didn't do the work. I'm not saying I get all the credit. I'm saying they came to me and trained and bought my book or bought like consulting from me or whatever, who are making over $300,000 a year. $300,000 freaking dollars a year. That's ridiculous. Okay? But most vendors, I've got a thing that shows you what the average is based on over 1,000 vendors. We got to really give us real numbers, real figures, and we got you the averages. So if you want that, that's on the blog. Just type in, type in the word salary in the search box. Salary, it'll pull it up. It'll be the first one that comes up. Learnhotdogs.com and then search boxes over on the right. If you're on a phone, it'll be all the way at the bottom. Don't know why that happens, but that's how it does on a mobile. So, Mr. Stoney, I want to do it, Ben, but still scared. Do a little at a time. That's what I was getting to a minute ago. See how quick I get sidetracked? Do a little at a time. Start small. Start like the donut lady. Okay? You don't have to do donuts. What I'm saying is you don't have to leave this to start this. Okay? I've got right now an attorney starting. An attorney. Yeah. somebody that spent, you know, $200,000 in college, he's starting. But guess what? Statistically, from the last Pew thing that was in 2015 or 14, Pew, that does Pew Research, you know, all the news agencies use them. Doesn't matter conservative or liberal, they all use them. Pew, because they're, you know, they're just straight to the point. Here's the results. We checked all these, and here's the results. Pew said that attorneys, there's more attorneys coming out of school than there is civil suits in America. They also said that there's that most attorneys are one paycheck away from being bankrupt. Most attorneys. Let's see. I'm 57, too old for it. Might be too old, slow, and lazy for a cart. Nope, I doubt it. Because you don't have to do a cart. There's so many ways to make money in this business without physically vending. I show you how to never touch a cart. I had a cart running and never saw the cart, and it made me money every single week, and I teach you that for free. It's over in my freaking blog, okay? I can't link all these all to you in one day. I'll give you 200 links, and you'll be like, Ben, stop. But you can go look it up. It's vending without a cart. Not vending without a cart. It's never see the cart. Put never see the cart. I think that's it. If you can't find it, email me, ben@learnhotdogs.com. I'll shoot you an email back with the link. Okay? I'm 60, waiting on Ben to get my big dog built. I'm on disability right now. Dragon Wieners and Catering, that is correct. She has her order in right now, and she'll be vending real soon. She's already got her catering. See, she started it the way we teach. She got her catering license, and she had to get a license there. And she started that end of it. She did tons of due diligence. Let's see. And let me tell you this, Nick Dice, you're right. Don't feel lazy. Get motivated for success. You can do this part-time. You can do this like Michael Wood. Michael Wood, you can look him up. You can look him up. Facebook, Doug's Dogs. DuggsDoggs. If you can't find him there, which you will, go to learnhotdogs.com and just type in the word Michael. Okay? He's on there a million times. A million times. He's one of my oldest customers, not oldest in age, but he's retirement, okay? But he's oldest customer because he was one of my first customers ever. And he's still vending. And he started vending about 3 days a month. Then he moved up this year to 8 days a month and makes a full-time income. He was making a full-time income with 3 days a month. And he's in Podunkville, Georgia, okay? He'll show you what he's doing. I filmed him, okay? I had him filmed and walk him you step by step of his day. How he sets up, how he serves, how he preps, how he cleans up, the whole deal. It's called, I don't know where the link is now. If you go to learnhotdogs.com, best day ever. That's where my free form is, so you can go work with a real vendor if you want to try this before you buy this kind of thing. Okay? Go work with a vendor. Doesn't cost you a dime. Okay? There's no catch. There's no gimmicks. And I'll even pay. Here's the catch. I'll even pay for your trip if you end up buying a cart from me. I'll pay up to $300. Not up to. It's an exact $300. It's $300 if you buy a cart after you do that. But you can go for free. But go to that site, and on that page, near the bottom, it says, don't have time to go see a vendor. Here's a vendor. You get the whole deal. You're basically at 5 years of experience in one video, well, it's a video series, and it's less than 10 bucks. Less than 10 freaking dollars. Let's see. What about the vendor that I filmed? I'm still stuck on this age thing. He was 70-something when I went and filmed him. Went all the way to Champaign, Illinois. It was Colonel Mustard's Last Stand. It was called Colonel Mustard's Last Stand. He had just purchased from me three more carts. He wanted to go bigger, okay? He was in his 70s. He had been vending 40 years, 40 years, okay? But it never expanded, found me, started expanding. I prove to you, I film him in a town with drunk bar kids. He starts at 11 at night or 10:30 at night and goes till 2 in the morning, okay, which is ridiculous hours. But he makes a killing. He gets 1,000 buns delivered each time he's out, 1,000 buns at each cart on bread racks. He has that much business. And he's in Champaign, Illinois. Now he doesn't do it. And we've got other vendors doing it over there. But he got cancer. Either way, you look him up. I interviewed him. I did an after show interview. I have tons of stuff free. That's all free. And that's all right here. You can look up Colonel Mustard. That's what he went by. His name was Dick Chapman. Richard Chapman. Dick Chapman. He was an awesome man. That tells you, if you want to do it, you can do it. And I hope that if you are wanting to start out slow, small, go check out this link, learnhotdogs.com/broke. Go check it out. Look at those stories. They started with nothing. Little to nothing. I'm talking a used crock pot and legally got started. And you may be going, that's weird. I don't want to do that. You don't have to do that. I show you a blue million ways to do this. Okay? I'm just showing you what they did. So there's different ways to do all this. I know I've talked forever, and I appreciate you putting up with me. What are things called that people walk around stadiums and fairs? What kind of warm thing they call? I do not know the name of that, but I can find it for you. Not right now, but I'll find it for you. Email me, ben@learnhotdogs.com, and say, what is the name of that walk around cart thing? And I'll get it for you. I don't even know how much they are. Let's see. The Day in the Life of a Vendor is the course name. Yeah, that's the course. I just didn't know the link, Nick. I appreciate that. My buddy had miniature donut trucks, but all cash, and workers ripped them off, stole cash. Here's what you do, how to avoid employees ripping you off. And I'm going to do this real quick, and then I got to go, okay? I have a course, and you don't have to buy this course. I'm going to tell you this information because the course has lots more that you may not need. But in that course, I had 22 carts at one point. It was a stupid move on my part. I had 22 carts running. I had headaches like your buddy with the mini donuts. Then I figured it out. I started paying people as much as I could possibly stand to pay them. And I gave them ownership equity. Okay? I gave them ownership equity so that they felt like they owned it with me. So they took ownership. No more theft I got. None. I never got another problem. Because I treated them, instead of you're my employee, I treated them as a partner almost. And I worked it out on a contract basis. So you can use my cart, my insurance, my license, my name, my everything, my food, okay? And we'll split the profits, or you get 20% of the profits. It depended on the situation. But I worked it out so nice that it just worked. But that's just one thing. You don't even have to have employees if you don't want, okay? There's a way to do this without any employees. Never touch the cart. I've done it, and now I've got other vendors doing this. I kid you not. I kid you not, other vendors are doing exactly what I'm telling you. And you can talk to these people, okay? I've interviewed some of them on here. There's a vendor, not a vendor, that I did this. I took a cart, okay? I'm going to give you the short end of it. And I put it up that you could rent my mini mobile kitchen on Craigslist. And I started renting the piss out of it. People wanted to rent my mini mobile kitchen. I didn't want to deal with it. I didn't want to clean it. I didn't want to pick it up. I didn't want to deliver it. So I had somebody else do it. And I just put it in the fee. So it got taken to a spot, dropped off at a spot. I made a automatic Google form. You can do a Google form where they fill out to rent it. That goes to an automatic Google calendar so you don't get double booked. That goes to an automatic like PayPal account. I use Stripe, but they paid it. I never saw the cart, never touched the cart, never nothing the cart, and made money all year round. All freaking year round. You can too. There's ways to do all of this stuff. Anyway, I love you. I gotta go. I hope you got some meat out of this. I know I covered a lot of topics and a lot of subjects, but it's meaty. There's plenty of meat. And here's what you do. If you don't agree with something somebody says, or let's say you find a good guru, or, you know, I call them gurus. But anyway, you find something and they may rub you the wrong way here or there. Don't dismiss everything. What you do is I had a preacher lady tell me this. I was walking out of a church. I was pissed. Preacher had said something. I don't even remember what it was, but it pissed me off. And I told my wife and kids, I said, we're leaving. We got up during service and we were leaving, right? I was quiet about it. I didn't put up a scene. Well, the preacher's wife come out there into the parking lot. We were already loaded up by the time she made it out there. And she goes, Ben, what's wrong? I said, I don't agree with this. That's just wrong. That's not what the Bible said or whatever it was. I don't remember. Okay? And you know what this lady said to me? She said, she's a black lady. And she just had soul. You know, she like a grandma. You know, like I could go eat collard greens with her. But I loved her. But she said to me, she goes, Ben, you got to eat the meat and throw out the bones. And that stuck with me for the rest of my life. Okay, I was a young dad at the time, ego driven, you know, even had a mullet. Yes, I did. I was business in the front, party in the back. Still, I was hanging on to my youth, right? Well, that one thing she said, eat the meat, throw out the bones. I turned around and went back in church with her because I got it that I may not agree with everything he says, but I don't want to miss the meat. I don't want to miss the meat. And that guy gave me some meat and I didn't want to miss that. You may not either. So sunflower seeds, chew and spit. Mr. Stoneley's right. Ballpark vendors use Hawkerbox, concessionequipmentdepot.com. That's a good one. Thanks for the link. Thanks for telling. Hey Ben, barbecue on a cart? Yes. Yes. I've done it. Got a video on it right here. I did it on my little dog cart. That's our smallest cart. I took an old little dog cart and I did barbecue. Today, I even talked about this yesterday. I did a killing with the barbecue. Anyway, I'll be launching with a standalone double steam table, brand new from Webster Aunt Store. Nick Dice, hit it, brother. Hit it. Hit it. You'll have to send us some pictures when you get up and going. That makes me happy. I like to see people doing stuff, taking action. Thank y'all. I love you, and I'll talk to you later.